Hello and welcome everyone. This is Lavender Sky Panther. Today is Wednesday, December 23rd, 2020, and today's topic is called Winter Solstice. It's a collection of images and sky observations happening on December 21st, 2020, and this time it's going to be exclusively photos from that particular day. And before we get going, I'd like to say good day, osio, how, buongiorno, guten tag, kia ora, jambo, kedu, buenos dias, bonjour, ni hao, tien dobre, konnichiwa, dobro hanya, annyeonghaseyo, buataji, dobri den, aloha winala, kalimera, and urendach. And today's starter image, we're just grounding down into nature before looking up into the skies, and this time it's a North American gray squirrel sitting alongside a canal bank. All right, now we get into the sky observations. If you're returning, thank you so much for being here. And if you're new, heartfelt thanks for joining me today. As you'll notice, when I'm moving forward, I'll have original photos and enhanced photos. When I say enhanced or enhancements, it simply means I've edited attributes of the photo, such as color, saturation, brightness, contrast, things of that nature, just to kind of pull out some areas of interest, highlight them a little bit better. You'll see as we go along. Now, in this particular case, I've got A listed here as an area of interest because I started noticing a slightly different character of the color in the sky. You know, otherwise we have beautiful, warm color signatures happening. So when I look to the right at the enhanced version, I'm just still tracking. It's kind of like a milky white phosphorescent glow, and it's a pointed ellipse shape. So I just am flagging that as note. It reminded me of the same kind of character of this kind of otherworldly aura happening when I noticed some cloak and craft emerging. Particularly in the show, an earlier show I did called Awe-Filled Sunset, and there was a cloak and craft that started to emerge, and you could actually see very concrete shapes and even machine parts to the extent that I could sketch overlay on them. So have a look there if you want to see a little bit more. For the rest of this show, there aren't so many examples like that where you can actually see machine parts, but I do have enough of them in previous shows. Anyway, let's see what else is showing up in the sky for this solstice. All right, so here we go. Here's another pair side-by-side viewing. So here's that area still, that like milky white. It still hangs in there even though I've put enhancement on the photo. And that always catches my attention. So when something remains white with a backdrop of either color or grayness, it does always call me to take a closer look. In this case, that's about all I yield out of this. But what starts to be interesting is letter B. So it kind of was starting to look like a dimensional object to me. So then we go to B1, and we see some a little bit of regularized texture to it. Very interesting. It starts to look like an object there, too. So we're going to take a look at this a little bit closer, and actually much closer. So here we go, B2. We're zooming in on this thing. And then B3, you know, it's a little out of focus, but you can tell there's some type of object, you know, hidden behind some of this cloaking material or vapor, whatever it is. You know, you see what you think might be happening there. It also looks like it's connected here beyond. All right, now this is just another side-by-side. Now in this case, I'm going to just focus on the right-hand side. The original's on the left, is the enhanced version on the right. Just there's a lot of different type of cloud quality and character going on in one scene. So we have this thing happening up above, and then here in the middle, this form is doing its own thing vertically. Then we've got this on a straight, you know, angle. And then this is more flat, almost, you know, near horizontal. So there's just a lot of weird activity happening in one scene, which should normally be drifting over the Miami skies as just cumulus clouds or something close. And here we got a whole lot of strange. So we also have a lot of choppiness, which is what I call staccato clouds. It means that something above or in this neighborhood is generating atmospheric disturbance. What I'm deducing is electromagnetic wave activity, or certainly some other type of wave activity happening through here. But see what you think. All right, now this is just an alternate cover slide I had, and the other one won out. But I'm just putting this here as a reminder, because on this sunrise coming up, it just had an interesting texture here. It was like a mist happening all over the place, and the way that the light caught in it reminded me of kind of like South Florida's version of an aurora borealis or northern lights, minus the beautiful greens and other colors happening, you know, in the northern lights. Anyway, let's see what's going on. So again, they're side by side here. So again, this was starting to behave, you know, very strangely. Haven't really seen that much before in South Florida. And then up above, we have a real white spot, you know, happening way high up, even though we've got all warm color signature happening below. So we're going to look to the right in enhanced version. And here we can just see the beautiful worm signatures happening here. And then something strange is happening up in here, you know. And again, why is this pure white or white blue when we've got so much color happening down here? Okay, then we're still looking at this quality of that, what I'm just calling South Florida's Northern Lights, so I guess Southern Lights. We're going to see it with some enhancement. And here we start to even pick up darker shadows. So these could be very well objects cloaking in this mist. Then we're going to look at just another scene here, and we're going to put enhancement on it to see what's really lurking below the surface there, of the apparent surface. So what caught my attention is we have all of these, you know, look at this curve, you know, bowed up here, and we have some little interesting backlight coming on this weird shape. And again, we've got so much movement, arcing and curving, but then this just goes straight up. So here it looks like actually a rectangular shape happening, this darker form, and then we have a triangular shape happening on this slightly lighter vapor. And it looks like there's a bottom of a form happening here beyond like a cloaking material. And when I'm talking about cloaking objects moving forward, I'm talking about something that could be 3D, very tangible, where you can touch it, very tactile. Or it could also be something interdimensional, or something 3D that's phasing in and out of dimension. So there's so many possibilities. But also in this photo, I'm noting this odd texture happening over here, where that could be something cloaking beyond. And then over here is very interesting. It reminds me like a very old school rocket ship, if you turned it on its side, where this would be, you know, the point to the top of the cone, and then these are the fins, and then the thruster at the bottom. And it's just all kinds of strange in here. So see what you think is going on with this scene. Also, as always, if you notice anything, there's going to be more happening in a photo than I can call out individually. If you see something I missed and you would like me to put it in a future show and cover it, let me know in the comment section below. All right, here's another interesting scene. We've got warm signature here at the sunrise. Then we've got these odd-shaped clouds and quotes starting to drift in. If you follow my cursor, we also kind of have an arc happening here. So we're going to look at this with enhancement as well. And here we go. So we've got, you know, definitely warm signature happening here, even to where we get a reddish band happening above. And then here, just, again, I've been doing this long enough to suspect that this could be cloak and craft, because we still got a very dark body, even though I've enhanced the photo. And even here, look at this shape. Looks like something else dark is happening here. And again, we have this arc. It looks like a surge of energy. Some type of electromagnetic wave activity happening, perhaps. Definitely some type of wave activity disturbing the atmosphere up here. You know, especially by comparison that this is all smooth. So see what you think is going on. Here's another scene where, again, we've got the smoothness of whatever mist is happening here. And then we have interesting things happening here. So we've got an object, looks like a cloaking object here, and you'll see why with enhancement, why I say that. Then we've got something coming on angle this way. And let's go ahead and jump to the enhancement to see more. So here we go. It looks like a very solid object here with edges to it, and also very symmetrical, like it has geometry to it. And to me, that is a very good indicator of some intelligent design. And then we have this one down here. We have like two parts. So to me, this looks like one cloaking object here and another one here as well. Then we have a silhouette that looks exactly like a little whale, like a cartoon type whale in the background. So there's, again, a lot of strange things happening in this photo, patterns emerging, these bars coming across. In addition, we've got what I call that staccato cloud going on. See what you think is going on in that one. Now we're going to take a look at this particular area where I have A. I'm going to look at that in more detail with some contrast and pull things out. Now here it starts to look like there's three little objects attached to this bigger assembly. And again, we just see this really choppy character. Something's definitely going on here. Then we have bright white happening in here and much lighter, you know, white light source, even though down here is supposedly the sunrise and it's very warm. This almost looks like a person lying down, you know, with the head and then the shoulders. anyway, let's zoom in and see what's going on at 8.1. So now we're going to look at 8.2, and it still looks like these are little things that are either attached to this bigger thing or two things, you know, if it's a craft there and a craft there, if it's overall one assembly, I'm not sure. But they're like jutting out from the side. So we're going to look at 8.3 without color. We're taking the color out just to see if we can see it in a different way. We start to see something in the shadows here, parallel, these like pipe-like shapes. And then 8.4, it's a little bitmappy, but I was just trying to get at, you know, are these things attached or are they floating on their own? Hard to say, but they definitely look like they have dimension and shadow to them. And then we're going to look at 8.5, the same scene with a little bit of color saturation change. And we do see like shadow, you know, coming off of some of these things. So it does look like they're hovering, and we still detect whatever's happening here beyond. All right, this is interesting because it's looking west, opposite all of the sunrise activity, and yet it looks like a different form of cloaking object or little objects cloaking. It's hard to say which is which, but we got a very odd cloud assembly here. And then, you know, look at these straight lines of white cloud happening beyond, and then this heavy sunken blanket, you know, of more, maybe more cumulus activity, hard to say, down below. It's just a very odd scene in general. Then we're going to look at that with some enhancement. I couldn't get it too much more in previous shows. I am able to pull out some more detail. That's about as good as it gets for this one, though. All right, here's another scene that starts to look strange because we've got a burst of bright white that's no, like, typical cumulus cloud or anything. And if anything, it's getting, like, obliterated with some motion happening here. And we have the worm signature still continuing where the sunrise is coming up, you know, off to the right of this picture. Then look at this. We've got some crescent, like, look like crescent moons here in form. And then we have this happening. And then this burst of whiteness as well. So we're going to look at that definitely with some enhancement. And here we go, just to, you know, better see what I'm seeing. Because how can we have everything has somewhat of a color to it, and then we just have bright white? So is this even a portal, are we talking? I mean, it's got a major burst of energy happening this way. And how are these forming? You know, these, like, crescents. Just very odd scene in general. And then we've got this overall form, which could be a cloaking craft. And over here, too, where my cursor is, this almost looks like some kind of form of a flattened triangle with rounded corners. And it has an echo, you know, in front of it, of this wave out in front of it. So that very well could be a cloaking craft in its own right as well. See what you think, though. And then here we go. We're going to zoom in on that one object with these crescents. And, you know, it's definitely looking like a cloaking object to me. We look at 8.3, though, because I'm looking down at 8.2. We're going to look at this area, because this looks more like an actual object with maybe even some symmetrical design to it, engineered design. So we're going to look at 8.3. This definitely looks like a triangular shape that's raised above with some shadow and dimension to it. And then we're looking at 8.4, again, taking out the color to try to look at it in a different way. And this also looks like an object attached onto whatever the flank of this thing is. I think that is some type of cloaking craft, but see what you think. Okay, hang on. Okay, I'm back. My apologies if you hear weird random noises in the background. I'm recording outside, so you might hear some loud neighbors. But anyway, here we go. Here's another side-by-side, the original on the left, the enhanced photo on the right. And here we have some, like, strange curved forms. We have this bright white, you know, white blue, light blue backlight on this form, and other strange things kind of floating through. And then here, too, gets very interesting. It looks like something's emerging out of some cloaking material. But see what you see in here. I also see, like, a triangle. This looks like a point at the top and the wider base of the triangle below. All right, here's another interesting side-by-side. So on the left is the original, the right's the enhanced version. Look at this arm coming down. And then this is a perfect sphere. An elongated, like, elliptical, spherical shape. So look at this round form, and it's round down here as well. You know, it looks symmetrical. And then we have this arm, like, almost like a half ring swirling around. And we have that same choppiness that I talk about. I like to call it a staccato cloud, meaning atmospheric disturbance. Then we have this burst of white, bright, light beyond, when below we still have that warm signature of whatever light source is happening here. So I'm going to say that we've got the original, maybe warmer sunlight source happening down there, and this is an artificial sun or solar simulator beyond. And if you look that up, you will find a lot of examples when you look up solar simulator, or look to a previous show that I've done called The Sun Is Not Alone, and I do show a patent from 1961, in fact, showing a solar simulator. So it just means it's artificial tech in the sky interfering with our normal sun. And do have a look at other Earth and Sky Watching channels on YouTube to hear more about what could be going on with that. All right, this is another scene of, you know, just caught my attention because of the strangeness of all the flurry of kind of busyness and activity with these clouds and the light beyond. So we're going to look at this with some enhancement. Here you go. And what catches my attention is this kind of more solid object here with a point on it. And, you know, there's just all kinds of strange in this photo if you look long enough. I'm going to keep moving on for time's sake. But do have, on your leisure time, you know, take a look in here and see what you can find. That seems a little bit odd. This one is interesting because I have A noted. We have an overall cloud that looks like a rounded bottom to a triangular shape. And then we have a very different, distinct shape happening right alongside it. And in addition, we have all this strange stuff happening below, all kind of cloud activity. And then we've got this white stuff happening even beyond that. which could be a cloaking system in its own right if you look at some of my previous shows that cover this. So we're going to look at this with enhancement, this time taking all color out of the photo. And we start to see this, if you follow my cursor, a triangular form beyond that holds true, even though I've put enhancement on the photo. So that tells me there's something cloaking and hiding in there. Then we also see these look like more parallel, regular arms on the side of something. So this could be a craft. You know, this could be the nose of a craft, and something's happening here and here of interest. But anyway, let's look ahead. 8.2, I've just outlined for you where I see that triangle, just in case it's easier for you to see it that way. And I'm going to toggle back. So if you look where my cursor is, there's that triangle. And then voila, there's the outline to show you what I'm seeing. Now, actually, this triangle, in truth, could even be extending up and over. It's just hard to see what exactly is going on because there's cloaking material around this thing. And let's continue on. All right, so here's another side-by-side. Just interesting. Original on the left and enhanced version on the right. Just because, again, it just seems like there's a shape, some type of craft or something cloaking beyond. You know, it has a very specific triangular character to it. And this stuff, it's whether it's, you know, plasma or water vapor or some other type of cloaking material, I don't know. So when I refer to cloaking material, that's what I mean, though. Anyway, see what you see in this picture. There's a lot going on. Actually, on the left-hand side in the original, it's a little easier to see. There's a huge triangular imprint as well, meaning the void is a triangular shape. If you follow here, you see a straight line here where my cursor is, and then there's kind of a more ragged line there, but it's definitely a triangular form. All right, then we've zoomed in on one of those clouds just to kind of get a better look to see what's going on. I see hints of things where this could be a separate object. Something's happening here, so we're definitely going to look at it with enhancement. Here we go. Here you start to see something that looks like it's reflecting light at the top, and here this is very straight, and then here there seems to be another straight line here as well. So I do think this is one larger craft, and that this might be one piggybacking underneath. I'm not exactly sure, but that's what it's seeming like to me. See what you think. Oh, and also beyond, you see this very straight line, so also with a point on it. So that also could be some type of craft parallel to this, or that's an arm of this thing extending out. But see what you think. And here we go, that same shape. There's that arm. Now I'm looking at it, and when I look in an enhanced version, that could even be a gun, like a gunner attached to this thing, like a big cannon-like gun. I don't know. But see what you think. There's a lot of kinds of strange going on with this photo. See what you think is happening. And this is also just illustrating on the right that we've got this warmer glow below of a light source that definitely has warm signature to it. And then above, it goes completely bright white and glaring. And if you've noticed in some of my other shows too, I refer to that there's this precise moment on the sunrises and the sunsets where we get a very dark object or quote-unquote cloud cover that does seem to be riddled with cloaking craft that come in and obscure our view right when we're trying to see this key transition where this warmer color comes behind this and then turns bright white and glaring, which again I think are then the artificial tech takes over, you know, and blinds out the original sun. All right, here's another view of the sky and looking east, and we just have some strange cloud moving over. Again, just overall weird character in the sky. And then we look at it enhanced, and we see some strange, like, shadow things happening in the back. This looks like a triangular shadow being cast. You know, there's just some strange ring-like things happening in here. And again, the more you look, it's kind of like the more you're going to find. And once again, we've got warm signature here being obscured by cloud, and then it's going to bright, bright white. So what is causing this bright white source of light? All right, here's another interesting view, because just of the dynamics of this, we've got this thing shooting off here, if you follow my cursor, an angle here as well, and then this goes in the opposite direction. Meanwhile, we have stuff that's more flat and straight across here, something very choppy over here. So you better believe we're going to look at this with an enhancement, and here we go. Now, what's interesting about this one is that we start to see actual shapes with hard edges, symmetrical, geometrical shapes, which is always an indicator of intelligent design. And then here we've got some edges hiding, too, behind some kind of cloaking-type cloud material. There's some kind of shape happening in here, too. I'm not sure if it's a triangle or something bigger. Anyway, we also have these weird bar-like fingers, you know, extending. Just a lot of strangeness, and they're coming down this way as well in parallel. So what's going on to cause all of this? And here's just another scene, too. Left is the original, right is the enhancement. And this just struck me as strange. There's a lot of things happening in here. that imply that there's a cloak and craft happening in that little mess. And then look up here. You know, this is also really strange in terms of texture, kind of light coming through, just very odd. I'm not exactly sure what's going on, but I'm leaving this up to you to decide. Also, we've got some like hard, black forms emerging. So this also is looking a lot like a cloak and craft to me as well. See what you think, though. All right, here's another view of the sunrise, and this time it's just glaring white ball. After having seen beautiful warm signature, you know, below, it starts to turn into this. So let's take a look with some enhancement. Now here it appears a little yellow on the enhancement, but really the golden warmth, you know, the color signature down below is more like this, and then up here it's, you know, like true white. So it's going in transition up to the whiteness. All right, here's another side by side. Just a really strange pattern to this sky on the left. So we're going to enhance it on the right. And look what starts to pop up where my cursor is. There's like a shadow of, I don't know if you're familiar in the U.S. with the Vicks cough drop. It's kind of like or a guitar pick even in shape beyond. And then there's weird texture in front of it, whatever is happening with this cloud material or whatever is generating waves to disturb it so much. Anyway, see if you see even more things in there that I'm calling out. All right, here's just a zoom in on one of those areas. We get a weird little structure here where my cursor is. Looks like it's attached to this bigger thing that almost looks symmetrical, you know, if you follow my cursor. Just a lot of weird little things are occurring in this view. So we're going to look at it with enhancement. And there you can see what I'm getting at. You know, it's really like pointed. Looks really strange if it's a cloud. So I think that's something cloaking here as well, because the character of this where my cursor is, that kind of foggy type smoke, looks like cloaking material cascading over something more solid to me. Anyway, oh, here too, here's this really bright point in a sea of darkness. It shows me also there's probably some piece, some actual 3D piece sticking off of something, and that's, you know, how you see that. And then there's just all where it's blurry, looks like something's coming or going. See what you think is going on in here, though. All right, well, here's the photo of the week and the close of the show. Just a little fun play on here's to seeing a great conjunction of a very different kind. Happy winter solstice. So hold on 1 second. All right, sorry. So if you're familiar with the great conjunction that just happened, you will know it was the alignment of Saturn and Jupiter with its moons and the sky. So anyway, I was just driving through neighborhoods looking at the Christmas and holiday decorations, and so I'm just making fun that, you know, there's a different alignment going on here because there's a whole lot of light activity going on in that scene. Anyway, I wish everyone a very happy holiday season. I do plan on coming back with another show soon, but in the meantime, just have a beautiful day, gorgeous now, gorgeous evening, wherever you are in the world, and I wish you tremendous peace and best wishes. Lavender Sky Panther, bye.